Hello folks, Jose here for another video tutorial for WPBasics.org. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to install the Genesis framework and a child theme. I will also provide a brief overview of the Genesis features. If you want more information about Genesis and reasons that you should use the framework, please check out my webpage. My webpage can be found at www.wpbasics.org. I currently have a fresh install of WordPress with the default 2017 theme installed. Here it is, you can see it here. I have added some test posts and widgets. Well, enough with the introduction. Let's get started. Step 1. The first thing that you'll need to do is to purchase the Genesis framework. The Genesis framework comes with a sample theme. We will be using that sample theme for this tutorial. Once you have purchased Genesis, go to the StudioPress.com page and click on My StudioPress on the top right-hand corner of the page. This will take you to a login page. Go ahead and log in. Your credentials for logging in would have been emailed to you upon the purchase of the framework. The download page that you have may look a little different than mine, depending on what themes or theme you have purchased. For this tutorial, all we need is the framework and the sample theme. Scroll down and locate the Genesis framework. Go ahead and download the Genesis framework by clicking on the blue download button. We will also need the Genesis sample theme. Go ahead and download it as well by clicking on the blue download button. Step 2. Now that we have the Genesis framework and the sample theme downloaded, let's head over to our web browser and check out our current install of WordPress. My test site currently has the 2017 theme, which comes as the default theme with WordPress. In order to install the framework, we need to go to our dashboard and click on Appearance and then on Themes. Now go ahead and do the following. Click on the Add New button and is located on the top left-hand corner of your screen. You will be presented with a new screen. On this screen, go ahead and click on Upload Theme. The next thing that you need to do is to click on the Choose File button. A new screen will pop up. Go ahead and locate where you want to download the framework and then click on Open and then on Install Now. A couple of important notes. You should always install the Genesis framework before your child theme, as the child theme will not work without the framework. And you do not need to activate the framework, as the child theme will be activated. Once the framework has been successfully installed, go ahead and click on Return to the Themes page link and repeat the above steps. Only this time, install the sample theme. The Genesis sample theme, or whatever child theme you chose, should now be activated. Step 3. Let's go to our web page and refresh the screen to see what we have so far. You will notice that the widgets that were previously in the sidebar are now gone. No need to panic. This is normal. Go ahead and navigate to Appearance and then Widgets. Whenever you install a new Genesis child theme, all of the widgets that you were previously using will be deactivated and placed in the Inactive Widgets section of your Dashboard, Appearance, widgets section. Go ahead and place the inactive widgets where you want them. Now go ahead and go back to your web page and refresh to see what we have. Success! You now have a page with a Genesis framework and a child theme. Step 4, overview. Now that you have installed Genesis and a child theme, let's go back to our dashboard and go over some of the features of Genesis. When you click on the Genesis link on your dashboard, you will see an option to have Genesis check for updates and email you a reminder. I highly recommend that you enter your email address here so that you are always aware when a new version of the framework has been released. Once you receive your update notification, you can then choose to update it or not. Below this section, you will see a place where you can enter your FuzzBead or FeedBurner RSS feeds. Enter the URLs here if you have them. Don't worry if you don't have them, they are not required. Next, we have a place where we can choose the site layout for our site. You can play around with these options and see which one you like best. Most blogs use the first option, which is a content section on the left and a sidebar on the right, but it is really up to you. You also have a section where you can decide where you want to show your breadcrumbs. Just click on the checkbox next to the page where you want the breadcrumbs to show. I will choose homepage, posts, pages, and archives. Below this section, you can choose to enable comments and trackbacks. I will enable trackbacks and comments for both pages and posts. In the content archive section, you can choose to display your entire post or just an excerpt. You can decide if you want the featured image to show and the type of pagination. I usually like the numeric pagination. In the blog template section, you can decide which categories will show as well as which ones will be excluded. You can also set the number of posts per page. Finally, we have the header and footer scripts section. Here, you can enter different types of scripts, such as your Google verification script. Well, you are now ready to move forward and create your masterpiece with the Genesis framework. I am always happy to help those that are just starting out with a Genesis. So if you have any further questions, please visit my webpage at www.wpbasics.org and shoot me a comment. I hope you liked this tutorial. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Bye for now.